story itself is a crime story, it's a love story, and it's also a dystopia. It's a very unusual crime novel. It's one man's search for his missing wife. The wife is a journalist who has gone missing investigating a series of murders. But however, as the husband realizes this, that the wife is missing, and he begins his search, he runs into, well, he runs into things that, you know, broaden his initial investigation into another investigation. The first investigation is about the search for his missing wife. The second investigation is the search into their marriage. And it's very much a story about marriage as well, because when you meet somebody and you marry them and you live together, you don't always think about it, but the truth is that person had a life before you. And, you know, not everything that happened in that life is something you bring into the next one. And there's, you know, there might be things that you keep to yourself and you don't tell everything. And so there are two investigations in the book. But that shouldn't keep you from reading it as a suspense story. All my books are stories that I felt that I needed to write. And it got its start actually very many years ago. There was at the time a lot of talk in the media about this phenomenon called climate change, which I found very interesting, because the scenarios that, you know, the scientists were bringing forth and you know, proposing were actually quite, if you thought about it, if you took those scenarios and you put them, you know, in your imagination, if you put them into reality, that would mean something quite terrible, actually. And I wanted to imagine what my hometown, Helsinki, where I've lived all my life, what it would look like if those, you know, if those forecasts and what the scientists were saying, I mean, what if that happened? I wanted to imagine that. So it's really, in that way, it's an investigation as well. I've written 5 books altogether. Now two are published in French. What all those books have in common is that they're both, each of them is both a novel and a crime novel. I'm sort of an in-between writer because I do a lot of things in my books that are part of, you know, what you call serious literature, because I write mostly about human relationships, about the secrets we keep from each other, the psychological aspects of what we do, the motivations, why we do things we do. And that's actually my main interest, you know, human relations, the way we interact, that's my main thing. But I also have this, as I said, crime fiction gives me the story structure. So I use, you know, elements of both. I was going to be a poet, and I still enjoy poetry very much. I actually love poetry, but it's something very, it's a strong connection with language. I write in Finnish, that I think is one of the most beautiful languages in the world, besides French, of course, but it's an important, it's actually one of the, I think, the main things in my books is the language, how it's written and how it's told. Actually, one of the writers that really influenced me and showed that, you know, anything is possible in a novel was a French man called Louis Ferdinand Céline. I read his book when I was, I think, maybe 20 years old, 21. And it was one of the books, not necessarily the story or anything about the book in itself, but something about, you know, the way it was done. You know, like, you can do anything, you can put anything in a book, and you can have different styles, you can use vocabulary that you didn't know existed, you can do basically anything and still call it a novel. And it was an eye-opener. It was one of the books, actually, that probably made me decide, or, you know, the strengthened my conviction that, you know, I'm gonna be a writer.